In this video, we're going to solve a polynomial inequality. The inequality here is 3x to the third plus 5x squared greater than 4x squared. The first thing we're going to do is get all the terms on one side, so we have our polynomial on one side and 0 on the other. We do this by subtracting 4x squared from both sides. This gives us 3x to the third plus x squared greater than 0. Now we need to find the critical numbers. We find these by solving the related equation where we replace the inequalities with equals. We solve 3x to the third plus x squared equals 0. And this is a factorable equation. We can factor the greatest common factor of x squared out. And when we do that, we get the equation x squared times 3x plus 1 equals 0. Now, when you have a factor times a factor equals 0, by the zero product law, we let each of those factors equal 0, and we get two solutions, or two sets of solutions in this case. We get x squared equals 0, and we get 3x plus 1 equals 0. Solving both of those results in x equals 0 for the first solution, and 3x plus 1 solved gives us x equal negative 1/3. Those are the critical numbers, x equals 0 and x equal negative 1/3. We plot those on the number line shown below here, 0 and negative 1/3. And we use open circles because this is strictly greater than. If it were greater than or equals, we'd use closed circles on the number line. So here on our number line, we've plotted those two points with open circles, and we're ready to continue with the next step. In this step, we are going to test each of the three intervals on our number line. In interval 1, we're testing the region where x is greater than 0. We pick any value of x greater than 0. So we pick x equal 1. It's a nice easy value. We plug it into our original inequality. Actually, we can use the factored form of it to make things easier. We plug x equal 1 into x squared times the quantity 3x plus 1 greater than 0. And this gives us 1 times 3 plus 1, which is actually 4, greater than 0. And that's a true statement. Since it's true, we shade the test 1 interval portion of the number line. So I'm going to shade that portion. And now I'm going to check interval 2. Interval 2 goes from 0 down to negative 1/3. That's a little trickier because it's a fraction. We have to pick a fraction that's between 0 and negative 1/3 on the number line, and such fraction would be x equal negative 1/4. We plug negative 1/4 into our factored form of our inequality, x squared times 3x plus 1 greater than 0. We plug it in, negative 1/4 squared is positive 1/16. 3 times negative 1/4 is negative 3/4 plus 1 is positive 1/4. That's a positive times a positive, and that is greater than 0, and that's true. So that means I would shade the portion of the number line from 0 to negative 1/3. But I would not shade the actual values of 0 and negative. So I'm going to shade that area. It's from negative 1/3 to 0, leaving the critical values themselves unshaded. Now I'm going to check interval 3. Interval 3 goes from negative 1/3 to negative infinity. So any x value less than negative 1/3 will work. Negative 1 is a convenient value to plug in. So we check x equal negative 1. We plug it into the factored form of the inequality, x squared times quantity 3x plus 1 greater than 0. X equal negative 1 squared is positive 1. And then we have 3 times negative 1 plus 1 is negative 2. Well, positive 1 times negative 2 is negative 2, and that is not greater than 0. So it's false. So since interval 3 tests out false, we do not shade that portion of the graph. So what we have left here as an answer is x is less than 0 but greater than negative 1/3, and also x is greater than 0. We have just this segment of the number line from negative 1/3 to 0, and then we also have the portion of the number line from 0 to positive infinity. But we do not include the values of x equals 0 and x equals negative 1/3 in our solution. We can write this final answer as negative 1/3 less than x less than 0, or x greater than 0, or in interval notation, we have negative 1/3 comma 0 with the round brackets on each side in union with the interval from 0 to positive infinity.